The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome, everybody, to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. Doesn't matter where you're at, Timbuktu or Kalamazoo, we like to come to you at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
Yeah, nothing? Nothing? Okay. What else do we have here? Go and take a quick look at the markets. Up 58 on the S&P, up 236 on the Dow, Nasdaq's up 326. And, of course, we're getting a bounce off the bottom, and that is not uncommon. We had a huge move down. We went a little lower. Volume is a little lighter. I believe that we're probably headed down into the mid 3200s on the S&P cash somewhere around May. It's going to take a long time. People are not going to give up instantly. They didn't give up instantly in 2000. They didn't give up instantly in 2008. In fact, all the broker dealers once more came up and tested a previous high or the previous highs of 3 months earlier on half the volume, every single one of them. A little different than none of these are actually the same. But if we can see something going out into the future, it's certainly the question of whether or not everybody's just going to pile back into everything one more time. You know what? It's going to be very tough to stay short. We got to see that. What else do we have going on? That's kind of it. Volumes. About 10 billion shares. So we've got we've gotten into this huge volume day starting last week, probably going to be pretty hard to exceed that 24 billion we had last week on the move down. You know what? We're probably going to just kind of gyrate around these levels for a while. Again, I kind of think that about 3250-ish is where most of my indicators show that we could pull back, and it wouldn't be anything but a move in a down or in an uptrend for a longer term. We've got a lot of people, a lot of new traders throwing money at the market, and that's going to be one of those things that makes it tough. Now, does it take another month to really break? I don't think so. We've got fun buying, and some of that's coming in today. Given last week, no one wanted to spend any money, so we got a little of that coming in today. But by Wednesday, it's all gone. So that is probably where we would want to look for the next leg down. Silver stock short interest. Yeah, we were talking to Pete in San Francisco, asked about the short float. And, of course, there's not that much in most of the bigger ones. It was AG and MUX, M-U-X, that we were talking about on Friday that had huge shorts. In fact, we've been talking about, 2-3 months? Where we had looked at the monstrous levels of short in MUX in those. And you know what? It's just one of those things. Every once in a while, you get these huge short covering rallies when everybody's just being a little bit too coy and thinking they can sit on their hands. The market will come by and take your money if you don't take it. So we'll see. Maybe we get one more move higher, but right now, Don't think so. Think that we're probably pretty close to extremely tough resistance that goes on. And of course, I've been watching, and we talked about it on Friday and Thursday and Wednesday. That is that advanced decline line that says that the market is pretty much in distribution. Now, can you get a big move in Apple that brings you up for a day, or the some of the semis? You can. But my guess is as soon as they get this, pop it up, maybe even by the end of the day, we'll start seeing selling once again. Probably level out here for a while. Like I said, maybe Thursday, Friday, we start seeing it again. Dave, do you think Robin Hood will survive? Yes. I know a lot of people are throwing things at him. It's tough to say. I'm not as tough on them about them not allowing you to buy certain stocks, because 20 years ago, I wasn't allowed to buy certain stocks. Even 6 months ago, from Interactive Brokers, they wouldn't like you let you buy into the oil contracts when those things were blowing out. Was it 6 months, 8 months ago? Brokers are there to, you know, they're a business. They're not going to be taking outrageous bets. They're no different than your local bookie. They won't take action if everybody wants to bet on one side. You just can't do that. You need to balance the sides. And I can imagine that a lot of people are probably, especially at Robinhood, skiing way over the tips of their skis. Now, I know a lot of people are saying, oh, it's rigged. They did it for this reason. They did it for that reason. My guess is the only reason what they're doing is to trying to stay in business. They mostly started the company as a way for small traders to do exactly this. But again, the law of unintended consequences. And two, there's a thing called Hanlon's law, or Hanlon's razor. And that is never attribute to malice what you can explain away by stupidity. And I don't think they're really stupid, but they're just, I've been at the very beginning of the launches of three or four products that I did. And, you know, I thought that if we sold 250 or 500 of them a month, the first 6 months on one of my products, I thought that that would be fantastic. We had orders for about 1,500 every single month for 6 months. And that actually then started, even after we got those first, 10,000 out the door, we had that. We had maybe 1,200 a month. I mean, we were selling as much as we could actually build. And was it because I was stupid or didn't know? You just, when you're looking at a still pond, it's very tough to know how deep it is. So I'm going to say that I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. Yes, I think they continue, but they're going to have to figure out the flaw in their business plan. It's no different than the folks at Twitter who haven't figured out how their place is. Be back in a minute.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I'll personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we're back. Let's do a little bit of history, and then we'll get into some charts.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1943, Japanese forces on Guadalcanal, defeated by the Marines, start to withdraw after the Japanese emperor finally gives them permission. Of course, it was going to be the unsinkable aircraft carriers, what the island hopping was all about. No one even knew that they had retreated. They woke up one morning and they were so stealthy that the Americans didn't even know that they were gone until they stumbled upon abandoned positions, empty boats, and discarded supplies. So they vamoosed this day in 1943 and one step forward into defeating Japan, which was going to be called VJ Day. Okay, so we got some decent volume. We're up 64 points on the S&P cash. We'll see whether or not we can break some of these first levels of resistance, which are right around this area. We're kind of at the very top of it at 64. Really, resistance started to come in as we hit plus 50 on the day on the S&P. Of course, you've got everybody trying to pile into everything, thinking that they once again have missed out. My guess is that we're going to see a lot of continuing distribution for months to come, but that's just me. I could be wrong. But so far, as long as I can sit on the right side and have enough move, I'm going to try to stay short as long as I can and add where I can too. Okay, so we've got that. Now, we had a lot of questions had some questions already today about the short interest. And that's what I was saying on Friday. Let's go ahead and get it here. Where's the scans? There they are. We were talking about the scans, and I don't know, I don't know how far we got into them. McEwen. Had a nice run, got up to $1.60 today. All these stocks have over, I think, 6 days to cover. I think McEwen had pretty good. Let's see. I actually have it, so let's go ahead and see if I can pull it up here. Come on. I don't know why. It's hiding behind everything else. Okay, shorts. Where's it at here? Okay, McEwen was the second highest on my list with 16 days to cover. So not beyond the scope of reason that this thing ran up and hit 160 today, given a little bit back and pretty much close to the end. But, you know, at 16 days to cover, you got some fairly decent volume, 50 million shares a couple of days ago on the gap up. But normally, and it's, you know, it doesn't work all the time, but normally after you get a gap like you did on, what is that? The 28th, you want to, you're probably going to get 3 days before you see a high. Now, does it work all the time? No. But if you are a betting man or speculating intelligently, generally the third big move higher in a short squeeze is where you want to get out. Does it always work? No. When you got 16 days to cover, though, it's something that you generally want to hang on. So, again, 3 days higher, are you probably got most of what you're going to get out of it? In the short term, the answer is yes. Now, whether or not more people short the stock, I have no idea. But again, this is what I talked about with Tom 2 months ago on why in the world would anybody be short a $1 stock? It's just nutty. And so while everybody's yelling at Robinhood and the Reddit folks, these people are just doing stupid stuff. If you got 15 days to cover on a 90-cent stock, you're just asking to get your pocket picked. Pickled peppers? Almost sounds like it. There were some other ones in here, but I think that was the one I looked at first. See. Go ahead and take a look. Okay. Now, some of the other ones on this lane have pulled back. The biggest loser on the day is Bed Bath & Below. Back on lighter volume, but probably going to, again, they ran all the shorts out of this fairly quickly. It's probably going to find some kind of support at 25 or 26, at least in the short term. Long term, it's probably going back to 15 bucks, but it may take 6 months to get the shorts out of it. Other big losers on the day that did have high short interest was Mascheris. This is down back kind of a similar kind of chart, down to 1347 today. GSX. Another one in the short covering range, and not much change in that one. Now on the winning side of these, the biggest one was DVAX. Okay. And that's Dynavax Technology, up to $11.69 today and holding most of it. As I said, once you get through the first big move, you've got to look on highly shorted stocks. You're probably going to get 3 days. So why I wouldn't chase it, I'm just not that kind of trader. You can keep an eye on it. But first day out of the big move, you actually had kind of you might even be able to call the first day out here the 25th, but it gave you a little bit of indication that you've had something going here. But again, you need those Reddit guys to jump on board if you're going to make the big wood. first Majestic Silver, another one with massive short positions. You had your first gap up a couple of days ago. You got your second gap. Probably going to get one more move out here probably before you set the high for the short sellers. We had that one, MUX is up 20%. AG's up 22%. Of course, it was up a lot more earlier in the day. See what else we have out here. IFF, another big winner in the short squeeze lottery. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay, I had some other questions in here, or statements in here, FSM and HL. The reason that I didn't bring them up so much is that they didn't have more than 6 days to cover. Now, Hecla did get up and ran everybody, but it's basically back close to the January 4th high after it gave it all up. That's why generally the big moves. Now, on this one, you've got two big gaps on Hecla. So you're probably going to get at least a little bit more out of there. I don't know how short it is. Let's take a quick look. HL. Certainly, they weren't shorting it on the day. It's only got 1.6 days to cover. So that may be everything you got today. So that's where I was going to say you got two gaps. But if you got a lot of shares short, no one was shorting it during the day. Give you another example on McEwen. The last few days, the shorts, in fact, were up a week ago to 35% and 30%. So you had people piling in on McEwen where you didn't on Hecla. What was the other one out there that I saw up there? Okay. Somewhere up here. Everybody started typing and it went by me here. Okay. FSM. Let's take a quick look at that. FSM. Fortuna Silver Mines. You got two gaps. I think what we're going to see that here, though, FSM, is, actually, this one's a little better. You had some daily numbers around 20% for the last few days. On the bi-monthly, you have about 2.4 days to cover on that. So, again, when you have the second MUX was the second highest days to cover in the stock market. There was only one stock that was more than that. What was that? Go take a look at it. SKT as the other monster. Tangier. Oh, we talked about this one. I forgot. It's already had its run. So SKT. See what they've been doing here the last few days. Yeah, 25% Thursday, Friday on the daily numbers, and 18.5 days to cover. So $10 to $20.96, not uncommon on the short squeeze side, FSM. Okay. Let's see. Okay, I got a couple emails here. Look at Microsoft. MSFT. Nice day, no volume though. My guess is we're going to see a lot of stocks like this. We're going to see a lot of action and volume that came in today was in the indexes and not that much in the actual stocks. But you got back up to the previous high, 40 or almost 40 that high, 242 on Microsoft. With 50 million shares, up with 22 million shares, and you got to 240, 250. So you're a dime under the high with what's going to end up being half the volume, maybe just slightly over half the volume. That's generally a pretty good sign that you've topped out. Like I said, a lot of these stocks, are they horrible? No. So are people going to run for the exits instantly? Probably not. But you have to look at it. Okay. Question about Gilead. G-I-L-D from Sam. You had a nice run up off the lows. You're up on light volume today. And not my pick of the biotech. It's okay. Certainly down at the 58, 59 level, it was making some good signs. But I think that's probably at 68, 38 is probably going to get you all you were going to get on this run. And again, I'm fairly bearish, so it's covered that way. Question also from Sam on Tesla. And whether or not people have quit shorting it. TSLA. Not as bad as it's been. They're still in the 20% range, which is kind of tall, a high for that stock. But the interesting thing out here is there is a fairly big sell signal on Tesla. You closed kind of just underneath it. You got it for a little few days. They only have one day to cover in the last reporting period on Tesla. Like I said, a lot of shorting intraday on this. A lot of people don't go home short on Tesla. But, you know, it's been shorted 40, 45%, 50% on some days. In fact, just in the last couple of weeks, back on the 14th, it was shorted 30% in one day. Now, you don't know on those numbers how many people covered before the end of the day, but it does show you that people are interested. Now, as it was going down Thursday and Friday, nobody got into those numbers. About 20% was the highest. If we see a real short number today, a real low number in the daily shorting, I think you're getting pretty close for a top in Tesla, where you could actually short the thing. Yeah, hepatitis. Uh, 500% short Tesla. It's only one day to cover. So it's, I mean, the shorts have left the building along with Elvis on Tesla. And certainly these last few days, not that big. To get into 30%, you have to go back to the January 4th. That was it. See the last really huge day out here. You know, they just, since it went past about $600, they really haven't started shorting it. And a lot of the people did give up on it. So there isn't that many shorts in Tesla unless someone came along in the last few days. But again, you'll see that on the daily going on. Navisite, didn't get much on that. What else do we have out here that someone was asking about? I think that's about it for those. Let's go ahead and look at Apple. Of course, everybody's going to want to jump in Apple if the market's going up at all. Not a big day out here. You have 130.21 on fairly decent volume on Friday. That probably suggests that you're going to get that tested. You're up today on 78 million shares so far, compared to 177 million shares, 142 million shares. So far, a fairly benign bounce in Apple. We shall return, just like MacArthur, to the Philippines.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com and hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com and hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And question about whether I like the 3D printers. I certainly like their products. I think they're way, 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 way out in front of what's going on, mostly because, again, super high short interest in these stocks, and they ran it. Now, on Stratasys, you got a three-gap play. That suggests that you could get all the way back to $22 and not hurt the breakout. You may have a huge trading range between 42 and 46 bucks over time, so I'd keep an eye on it. But I'm going to say that at least half of this big run, which you have pretty much the same thing, you've got three, I wouldn't say huge gaps, you've got three nice gaps in 3D, and you can probably trade these out. But you would love to see pretty much 3D DDD come back to about 20 to 18 bucks on light volume, and that would be something. But well, both of these things had monster short sell numbers, and generally over time, massive shorts mean that you get one big move, not that you get a sustained move. After they run everybody out, as they did in 3D systems, from 10 to 44 bucks. But, you know, this thing had 8 days to cover, 10 days to cover before it started heading up. So, you know, that's not it. Now, on the dailies, no one's shorting it. So, I mean, if you thought this was going to go much higher, you have to go back to the 15th to find anybody, any single day that had more than 20%. And actually the 12th, you had 31%. But the last week, I actually can show you, because I keep track of this stuff. Should be able to highlight it here. I mean, you really didn't have a big day. And even on Friday, no one was willing to pull the trigger on 3D systems. It had 9% on the whole day, which is, you know, you can attribute that easily to just market makers making a market, nothing else. What I want to see is a great, if you wanted to think these were going higher, you'd want to see a lot of people still shorting them. And again, the big moves down on these stocks are going to happen because there are no shorts. And as soon as people get to selling, you're going to see the huge move down. And does that mean it's over? No, they had good earnings. Both SSYS and DDD have some new technology, and it's a great thing. But was it worth 44 bucks? No, it was worth 44 bucks because there was 10 days or 8 days to cover on it. And, you know, could it come back to 23 bucks? 22 bucks, something like that. I think it could. Now, maybe it doesn't. If everybody starts shorting it, could be problematic. My thought would be, yeah, it's probably more of a short here than it is a long with no one shorting it. Quick question about whether or not I can show SSYS's daily shorts. And again, 10% can be made with or 12%. On a lot of these stocks can be just made up of people of the market makers just making a market, going long and short to keep things moving. They are the auctioneers of the market. They'll make trades just to keep things liquid, and they'll go short for a little while, go long for a little while. But SSYS, the last big day is shorting. If you wanted to call it the 8th at 19%, but it was really the 7th at 25%. Now you're down to like 9% on one of the worst days in the market ever, and you can't get anybody to short it. That's generally a good indication of a top, not a bottom. Okay, take a quick look at here, see what's going on. And we're up 68 points, 2783. Take a quick look at the volume. So we're going to be going back into this downtrend that had about 22, 23 billion shares. Right now we've got 11.5 billion. So again, I'm going to say that when we look at it, we're going to see a lot of stocks up on very light volume over the next couple of days. And of course, a little bit of earnings out after the bell, but nothing significant tonight. It's more in the morning. After the bell tonight, we've got NXPI. To take a quick look at that. Yeah, no shorts in it either. The last few days, about 2 days to cover, so not a whole lot. If you see any kind of whiffing in this one on light volume, I would say on the upside, a really good one takes you to 182. A bad earnings call takes you to 156. So that may get a good idea about how some of these are doing tonight. And of course, really, it's tomorrow where we start seeing the big heavy hitters come up. And I think a lot of people are getting long thinking that these are going to be the big winners. UPS, I think the chart really suggests it's going to come back and fill 130. So you could see a big move down tomorrow if that is true. BABA has its own issues with China. Take a quick look at that one. And, of course, we only have a kind of a window on the world on this that's kind of extended. It's just going sideways on it. Pfizer also in the morning, PFE. Okay. Yeah, these drug companies do not look good. Let's look at the BBH. Yeah, if you, the next, dip underneath the 3x3 line would be a double repo and would say that you could come back, to the BBH. What is that? Why am I on the wrong one? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It would take you back to 170. Okay, what else do we have out here? Exxon Mobil, XOM in the morning. Take a quick look. Now, you're at support on this, but it's about half the volume. You actually had a fairly good day up on the 5th of January with 44 million shares. You're down into that with 15 million shares. Doesn't look too bad, actually. Did have a nice run higher on volume. Volume has been okay on the way down, but not horrible. You might have something starting there. Okay, HOG. Everybody buying motorcycles to ride around since they don't have to, or they don't have to worry about social distancing on the hog. Okay, we got 1 second left. And it's pretty much sitting up here. I don't know. I'm fairly bearish. I think a lot of things back. It's a big gap starting them higher. A hog indeterminate. Look at your short interest, both daily and bi-monthly. When you return.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
One of the other earnings in the morning is going to be Harley Davidson. And I thought I'd seen this, but I didn't remember it. Now that I looked at it, almost 11 days to cover on Harley Davidson. So if you're watching this in the morning and they don't go down, you're probably going to find some short folks that want to get out before the end of the day. So that may be yet another one. Again, I'm not going to be in any stocks that don't have a decent amount of short interest long. You need something out there as a cushion if we do turn down hard, give you a little bit of time to get out. The ones that I'm really worried about are these stocks, as we said, where no one is shorting them like Tesla. Certainly not like they did. One day to cover, 10-15% during the day and not building up any kind of short interest. Where once they had 40% short interest in Tesla. Those are the ones where you start seeing that there is a lot of downside if people want to turn on it. Generally, when you get up to $900, it goes to $1,000 no matter what. That would be the one downside on the Tesla. Do you have anything else out here? Gold miners, no, we talked about that earlier in the show. It's the silver stocks that really you want to look at, AG, ASM, HL, and CDE. Both of the all those have a lot more than most of the gold stocks. Don't know why everybody shorted the silver and not the gold, but I think that's something that goes on all the time. What do we have left when we go into the end of the day? Okay, we're up 68 points on the S&P cash. Volume still about half of the day's down, 24 billion shares. We're doing about a little less than 12 billion shares now. So light volume bounce, I think, in a down market. We're going to need a couple of weeks to get going. Of course, it is a little bit of fun buying. That's over on Wednesday. So we shall see. So when you can, not when you have to. We will be back here tomorrow, just like that.